Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to be considering the laws of logarithms. They are also called the theories of logarithms. Now, these are the laws. Irrespective of the base, the logarithm of AB is going to be equal to log A plus log B. The second one, log A over B is equal to log A minus log B. And finally, log a raised to the power of n is equal to n times log a. So the logarithm here can assume any base. It can take any base. It could be base 10, base 5, base e, base 20. It can even take a negative base. Okay, so these are the laws of logarithm. What we see here is that when a multiplication is between a and b, the log can be splitted between a and b to include an addition sign. So here is a multiplication, a times b. On the right, we've got a positive. So what it tells us is that the logarithm of a product is equal to the sum of the individual logarithms. In the second one, the logarithm of a quotient. Quotient is another word for division. So we can see a divided by b. So the logarithm of a quotient is equal to the difference of individual logarithms. So finally, what happens here is that this power, this index, multiplies the logarithm of a. Now, these three laws are very relevant, and we are going to be using them to solve a number of problems. Evaluate log 0.0001 base 10. There are a number of ways of solving this using the laws of logarithm. I'm going to apply two of those here. The first one, so solution, log 0.0001 base 10. The first is to recognize that this decimal right here is 10 to the power of negative 4, because we can shift this decimal point 4 steps to the right. So that's going to give a negative 4, 10 raised to the power of a negative 4. Okay, so this looks like the third law, because n is negative 4, a is 10, and of course our base is 10. So this is going to be negative 4 times log 10 base 10. So this is negative 4 times log 10 to base 10 is 1. And we can see that log 0.0001 base 10 is negative 4. Now, the second way of doing this, evaluating log 0.0001 base 10, is by expressing this decimal as fraction. And that's going to be log to base 10 of 1 over 10,000, because 10 raised to the power of negative 4 is 1 over 10 raised to the power of 4, which is 10,000. Or, and that way of doing that is, of course, by shifting the decimal points, and this is going to be 1 over 10,000. So, relying on the second law, so we can see that a is 1, the numerator, and b is 10,000, that's the denominator. So if we apply the second law, log a over b equals log a minus log b. So log 1 over 10,000 base 10 is going to be log 1 to base 10 minus the negative here, log 10,000 base 10. Now I would want the number here to tally with the base. And so I know that 10 raised to the power of 0 is 1. Of course, any number raised to the power of 0 other than 0 is 1. But I'm not going to go for 5, because I want a situation whereby the number and the base will be the same. So my bet is 10. So this is going to be log. So 1 is 10 to the power of 0. So I've got a base 10. Minus, so 10,000 is 10 raised to the power of 4. Now, The third law comes in. The third law, log a raised to the power of n equals n times log a. So my n here is 0. A is 10. So this is just going to be 0 log 10 to base 10 minus, right here, n is 4 and a is 10, comparing with the third law. So this is going to be 4 log 10 base 10. We know that log 10 to base 10 is 1. So this is going to be 0 times 1 minus 4 times 1. 0 times 1 is 0 anywhere in the world. 4 times 1 is 4. So 0 minus 4 is going to give a negative 4. Okay, so let's take one more. Write log 60 in terms of log 2, log 3, and log 5. So let's do this. We are going to be relying on one very elementary concept in mathematics. That's the expression of a number in terms of the product of its prime factors. So doing that here. Okay, here is it. So we can see that 60 is equal to 2 times 2 times 3 times 5. Therefore, I can write log of 60 as the log of 2 times 2 times 3 times 5. Okay, so 2 times 2 can just be written as 2 squared. So this is 2 squared times 3 times 5. Now we can see that this is the logarithm of a product. So the first law is going to help us resolve this. And we are going to have log 2 squared plus log 3 plus log 5. I'm sure you are wondering, oh, but this is log AB. Yeah, this law extends beyond two items. So we can have ABCD and it's still going to be equal to log A plus log B plus log C plus log D. So it's not restricted to just two items. Okay, so the third law is going to help us here. Log 2 squared, here is an index. So this is just going to be 2 log 2 plus log 3 plus log 5. That's our final answer.
I hope you found this video useful. If you did, kindly like, subscribe, and share it. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.